Welcome back to my series on having a narc-free new year. And for those of you who don't know, it's where I'm reading excerpts out of my book, Healing from Narcissistic Abuse, Recover from Empathy Deficient Relationships, and Emotionally Unavailable People. If you want the links for it, it is going to be down below. And also, if you missed other videos in this series, I will have them at the tail end of this video, so you can just click on through. With that said, let's get on with it. Okay, page 68 of chapter 3 on childhood programming. Why do you attune to those who don't attune to you? This lack of attunement creates a lot of unnecessary pain. Why didn't your parents attune? Why are your life partners not attuning? More importantly, why are you not attuning to your own emotional needs? Why do you attune to people who don't attune to you? It's because of risk. Fear of losing control of reality. Now, the narcissists, the people who live in their own egocentric bubble, are going to argue that their approach is best, that it's a very good approach because they are creating their own reality. But the truth is, they're creating the reality they want through resisting what is, by forcing what isn't. They are creating a false reality. At times, the narcissist can seem genuinely caring, but the reality is that they're doing it to avoid some kind of conflict. They're merely placating or pacifying, and it isn't really caring, it's being done to avoid conflict. This is what causes them to try to rush in and force solutions or avoid feelings, which ultimately prevent finding honest resolution. Because again, it's about avoiding conflict or confrontation. Unfortunately, narcissists are people who live in this egocentric, self-focused, and self-reliant bubble. They're overly concerned with how they feel, and they fear that attuning and connecting with others is going to badly affect how they feel. They're afraid of committing to people who will ultimately be uncommitted to them. They're afraid of attaching more deeply to a person than that person is attached to them. This is why we have intimacy problems. And even within ourselves, as codependents, it's all created in homes where children are shamed for emotional neediness. So what do we need to do? We need to seek out people who are emotionally attuned to us and are willing to harmonize with us on an emotional level. Again, this might be very foreign because you probably didn't grow up in a household where this was existent. Being in attunement is about harmonizing or being at one with the feelings of another. It's about tuning into another person, what they feel or imagine, what their emotional experiences are. This was often avoided in our households because people wanted to avoid conflict. And as I said before, the inability to emotionally attune with others is likely stemming from someone who never matured beyond the egocentric stage in childhood development within basically the first 2 to 3 years of life. So they cannot empathize with others. They're in their own little egocentric bubble where they're unaware of other people's realities, and quite possibly, blissfully so. All they know is their reality. All they want to know is their reality. Like a 2-year-old, like a toddler. So if you come from the opposite end of the spectrum, where you learn to attune to others as a matter of survival, because you were brought up in a home with CEN, childhood emotional neglect, then perhaps you learned to attune to people who are not attuning to you. And think about it. Did the people around you acknowledge or invalidate you when you expressed your feelings growing up? When your parents didn't attune to you, one of two things usually was learned by the child in those situations. Number one, that your survival depends on retreating into yourself and becoming self-reliant, which is the narcissist's approach. Number two, your survival depends on hyper-attunement and hyper-vigilance to the parent and the caregivers in your environment, and this required you learning how to tune out your own reality, to get out of tune with your own emotional needs, and this is the approach of the codependent empath. If you're interested in purchasing this book, Healing from Narcissistic Abuse, Recover from Empathy Deficient Relationships and Emotionally Unavailable People, remember, it is on Kindle ebook version. You can get it on audiobook at Audible, and you can also get it in print at Amazon.com. And for those of you who like to sit back and watch and listen, well, I've got the video version over at my Etsy shop. Links for all of these are going to be found down below. And if you want to watch the next video available on narcissism, click here. Thank you all for your support.